Hello Adventurers, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create online attendance app using MIT App Inventor. So here we go. So first we need to click on start new project, click on this, and my project name is AWT and OK. In this app we are going to take attendance online, or we will save their attendance directly to the Google Sheet. So we need here two things. First thing is face recognizer. Okay, so what we will do, we will create model here. Okay, so it's an AI model. Okay, so that's the link I will show you. Open the new tab and just type here App Inventor classifier. Okay, and as you can see, the classifier.appinventor.mit.edu. open this. Now as you can see, click on this plus icon and you can define their label. So suppose let me just define the Sabrina, okay, and enter. And now I need to put Sabrina image. Okay, so you have some student, so you need to put their 3 and 4 images in that label. Okay, so let me just put the Sabrina images. So I have that. Okay, so what I will do, I will just put all these 2 images like here. Okay, and this is called Sabrina. Click on again and I just say the Tony star and enter in classifier like this one, and I have one more, this one. So let me just create one more student is Alon. And what I need to do, I need to just click on train here and wait some seconds. You can put multiple students' images here, okay? And the website name is classifier.appinventor.mit.edu. I will give you that link in the description. So that's the first step to create model in our app. Okay, and as you can see, the model is created and classification is Alon, Tony and Sabrina. So let me just put one image here, okay? So what I will do, I will put the Tony image here, okay, or Sabrina image. And let's see how this app will detect this image as. As you can see, the Sabrina, its confidence is 98.95. okay, so now this model is working fine. Now I need to click on export model, and that's my, I have model.mdl file. So go to the MIT App Inventor, and that's our app here. Okay, it's a first screen. So what I need to do, I need to just drag and drop here one label like this, one web browser and one button. It's simple. And click on label and make this as a result like this, make it 20. Click on the screen and make this an inner center, both things. Click on that button and change that to attendance. Attendance, make it 16 and make this background color to the pink or something. Cool. Now that's our app here. I will change that screen name also. So from here I will just say attendance like this. Cool. So now that's our app here. Now I need to drag and drop one more thing is web. So left side you will find the option of connectivity, and as you can see the web, just drag and drop it here like this. Now click on extension. Okay, and we need to download, we need to upload one extension here. So go to the MIT App Inventor extension website. Okay, that is a GitHub link. I will give you that link also in the description. You need to download personal image classifier, this extension. So download this, go to the MIT App Inventor, click on import and import that extension here. Just drag and drop that extension here. Okay, and in the right side, as you can see that model, see in that extension, click on that model and click on upload file. And we already have exported one model. Okay, okay, so we already have uploaded one model, right? So we need to drag and drop that model file here and okay, it's done. Okay, so that's our model. Now you can input mode is video and the image, so I will choose the video like this. Cool. So that's our design part. Now go to the blog section here, and now we need to click on this personal image classifier. And as you can see, when the personal image classifier is ready, then I will change my label name, set label text to true, or I just say the ready. Okay, so it's just like, it takes some seconds only to ready like this. Okay, so when it's ready, then I can capture the image. Okay, so what I will do, as you can see, when the got classification, I will call classify video data, this one. But when I need to call this, I need to call this on that button click. like this. So whenever someone click on that button, so we need to classify all that video data, okay? And whenever we classify the data, it means when the got classification, this one, then we need to use your condition. Simple. First, what we will do, we will set the username, it means classify data name, okay, and the classify status or classify result we have to display in label. So it's simple, set label, or you just copy from here, set label dot text, and this is, it's a result, or it's not a text value, it's a list value, okay. So what I will do, I will click on list here, and I will select the first item from the list, okay. So list, select list item, this one, and from which list, it's a result list, and the index is 1, okay, this one, like this. So what I will get the higher percentage value. If they if the software is confident about Sabrina is 95%, so this will display in the first, okay. So we will get that first letter, first name. So what I will get that something like is JSON format. So what I will use here one simple condition. I can replace that text, one thing that I can do, or I can do one more thing is here, I can use simple condition here, okay. So there are a lot of way to display the name, okay. So it's simple way, I will show you. If click on text, and as you can see, if the contain text, it contains text is Sabrina, okay. So if says like Sabrina, then it's a piece of text is Sabrina, and in which text, in the label 1 text, okay. So label 1 dot text is Sabrina, then I will set that set label value to the Sabrina, like this. So I need to do simple thing again, else if I will choose here, else if 1, else if 2, and the same thing I have to apply again, label 2, and if that contain is Tony, okay, then I will set that label is Tony Stark, like this. And same thing I have to apply again is like if the label is value is Elon, then I will set that is value to Elon Musk, like this. Now this thing will classify the data. Now we have a result. Now we have to upload that result, we have to save that result in the Excel sheet. So how we can do this? So go to the My Drive, okay, and in the left side you'll find the new option and click on Google Sheet, okay. So we have to save our all values, entry, attendance in that sheet. So I will just say that my sheet name is attendance new, okay, and that column name is name, like this, okay. Now go to the MIT Applementer, go to the My Drive, sorry, and we need to create one script, we need to write one script. So I will give you that code, okay. So click on new, and as you can see, click on more option, and you will find the app script, Google app script, click on this, and we need to write simple code. So we just need to copy and paste that code. So I will give you that code, okay. So I have that code, so in the Google, and just copy that code, okay, and we just need to paste that code here like this. And we need to change in that code, what we need to change here, okay. So as you can see here, spread sheet, this one, so we need to change that sheet link, okay. You have to change that. So what you do, you need to go to the sheet option that we have created, click on share option, okay, like this, and you will get the option of restricted. So just select this to any with this link, okay, anyone with this link, click on that copy link, okay, or you can select that editor, make sure, because we have to edit that. So anyone can edit in this link using that copy link, and then done, okay. Now go to the untitled project here, and we need to paste that link here like this, paste it. And again we need to do same thing here again, like this, okay, like this. Now what we need to do, we need to deploy this. So click on deploy here, and new deployment, so save, or you can just first save that project. So I just say AWT, and that rename this, okay, just save that project, and deploy this, and you just say new development deployment. And you find the option of your setting, click on this, and as you can see the web app, just select this description, you can close it, or attendance app, web app as user accessing that web app, who has access, anyone with this Google account, and deploy this. Done. You just need to copy that link here, okay, and just click on done. Now just go to the MIT App Inventor project, and we need to click on that first procedure. We need to create one procedure simple here. On the procedure, we will call this web, and this web is, we need to call this URL. So set web URL, this one here, and I will set the text is empty like this here, and we need to copy this text to here. Just copy that link from here and just paste it here, okay? And then we need to save, we need to call this link with the name. So what I will do, I will just first test this one is working fine or not. So what I will do, I will open new tab, just paste it here, okay, and then I'll just say question mark name equal Saurabh, and then enter. Let's say it's working or not, on fine or not. Wait some seconds. See what we have done. Whenever I paste this, as you can see the review permission, so I need to click on review permission, and I have to sign in with my Google account, and I have to allow this, okay. Click on advance, click on go to the HTTP unsafe, yes, and you need to allow this, click on allow. It's done, okay. Make sure you have to test this. This script is completed, and let's go to the Google sheet here and see that printed Saurabh. So we need to apply that code in our app inventor, okay. So make sure you have to done this simple part to allow the permission to the script, okay. So let's go to the MIT app inventor, okay. We already have pasted it. Now we just need to call this one here, it's called text, and you'll see the join option. Click on web, and you see the post option here, post text, this one, okay. So this one, just call it here, click on join. And we need to just say the text is name, okay, name equal, and we need to, another thing is that the value is our label one, okay, label one dot text. It's simple, cool. Now what we need to do, we need to call that procedure on button click, okay. So on that button click, that see we have classified the data, right. So what I need to do, I need to call that procedure. So I will call that in that here. So just call this procedure and call this procedure after completing that process, after this completing process, right. So we need to call this, it's simple. Now just, or you can just change the procedure name is AWT like this. So go to the design and click on personal image classifier, and you will see the web viewer. So we have to select any web viewer. So we have drag and drop that already web viewer one, so select this one like this. That's the amazing app that we have created. So if you need any help on that, so just comment on the video. I'll try my best to solve your problems. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.